In one of my earlier videos, I said that as engineers, we care more about building useful machines than understanding how the human brain works, in the context of artificial intelligence. However, understanding the human brain and behavior can inspire us and give us an edge on building useful machines. So, I wanted to make a few videos about some of the topics in cognitive science that can inspire us to build better, smarter, and safer AI, computer vision, and virtual reality systems. In this video, I want to talk about an interesting phenomenon that makes us hear images and see sounds. And I'm not talking about synesthesia, which is a neurological condition that happens only to some people. People who have synesthesia couple two or more senses with each other, such as associating sounds with colors and tastes. Some people think synesthesia is a disorder, and some others think it's a gift. For example, some artists with synesthesia use their ability of joint senses to their advantage in their art. Synesthesia affects some 4-5% of people, but perceptual fusion is something that most of us experience. Let me show a few examples. Do you hear a thumping sound when watching this video? Well, you shouldn't, because it has no audio. What people see here seems to interfere with what they hear. Such multimodal fusion of vision and hearing is not new. In 1976, McGurk and McDonald showed an example of a fusion of auditory and visual perception called the McGurk Effect. Let's take a look. What do you think this man says?
Ba ba, ba ba, ba ba.
And how about now?
Ba ba, ba ba, ba ba.
And now?
Ba ba, ba ba, ba ba.
All three clips have the same audio, but depending on the lip movements, we hear it differently. A very similar effect is observed in ventriloquist performances.
Look, 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 who are these people?
These are the judges. They're staring, it's rude!
The mouth movements of a puppet shape the perceived location of the sound from the performer to the puppet. Both McGurk and ventriloquist effects are examples of where visual cues change the way we hear. Let's take a look at examples that do the opposite. Okay, you're about to see a flashing disc. How many flashes did you see? And how about now? The disc flashed only once in both times. However, the second one was accompanied by two beeps, whereas the first one had only one. Let's take a look at it again. If you saw two flashes in the second one, like many of us, then this is an example of your hearing affecting your vision. Let's take a look at another example. Do you see discs passing through each other? Let's watch the same animation with the audio on. How about now? Do you see them hit each other and bounce? This was another example of auditory cues changing our visual perception. Audio and vision are not the only senses that interfere with each other. What you see can even impact what you feel as a physical touch, which brings us to the famous rubber hand illusion. In the rubber hand experiment, subjects had their left arm hidden out of their sight, and a rubber hand was placed in its place. When researchers touched the real and the rubber hand with a paintbrush at the same time, the subjects started to have an illusion of ownership and felt like the touch sensation actually came from the rubber hand. In another study, when the rubber hand was threatened with stabbing, the subjects started to sweat and had brain activity related to pain anticipation, as if there was a real risk of injury. There are many ways our brain fuses cross-modal perceptual information. What you smell can affect what you taste, what you hear can affect what you see, and what you see can affect what you hear and even touch. That's all for today, I hope you liked it. Subscribe for more videos. In the next video, we'll talk about how humans and AI systems can cheat to achieve a given goal and what can be done to prevent unexpected consequences. Alright, thanks for watching, stay tuned, and see you next time.